How's it going, everybody? As mentioned earlier in the newscast, one of the most bizarre and troubling sports scandals in recent memory has hit extremely close to home, as former Notre Dame linebacker and Punahou graduate Manti Te'o says he was scammed, falling for what he described as an online relationship that was later discovered to be a hoax. Now, following the release of a stunning report by the sports entertainment website Deadspin.com, Te'o says he was led to believe that 22-year-old Lene Kekua of California, who he spoke with and had ongoing dialogue with on social media, tragically died of leukemia in September, quickly gaining national attention. Now, in early December, while at an award show in Orlando, Te'o was contacted by the woman believed to be Kekua, informing Manti of the hoax. Now, a part of a statement released today through Te'o's agency, CAA, Manti said, quote, "to realize that I was the victim of what was apparently someone's sick joke and constant lies was and is painful and humiliating." Now, the Deadspin article does question who may have been involved in the scam, although the Te'o camp has claimed to be the victim. Now, Notre Dame echoed those sentiments. In a press conference this afternoon, athletics director Jack Swarbrick stated that the school launched its own private investigation and came to the conclusion that Te'o was the victim of an elaborate scam featuring fictitious family members of his believed girlfriend, which could have led to extortion in the future. And late tonight, in a strange twist, former UH running back Regan Mau'ia told ESPN that he indeed has met the alleged fictitious Kekua in American Samoa and believes that she is a real person. Now, as for reaction here at home this afternoon, our Sam Spangler caught up with Punahou head football coach and Te'o's 2008 state champion mentor Kaleane, who expressed obvious shock.
Is Manti susceptible to this because he's such a trusting individual and because he puts so much into his faith?
Yeah, again, it's all speculation at this point. I think, you know, we're wondering why this would happen and how it would happen, just like anything else. But I think he's such a sensitive person and faithful and trusting guy that I'm sure that had a big part of it as well.
Now, as many begin to try and wrap their heads around this story, the question of how this will affect Manti's future in the often cynical NFL is no doubt considered. And exactly 100 days away from the National Football League draft, ESPN analyst Mark Schlereth lent his thoughts.
There are a lot of good men that play in the National Football League, really good men. Mm-hmm. And there are a lot of guys that aren't. All right, let's just put it that way. And so talent always trumps, in many cases, or oftentimes trumps, I shouldn't say always, but oftentimes trumps guys who have a lack of character. And I'm not saying that about Manti, because I don't know, but they're going to do their homework in regards to, did he participate in this hoax, or was he just the victim of what is truly a cruel and terrible, you know, practical mm-hmm. joke, if you will. It's deeper than a practical joke, but certainly, it's cruel and it's a terrible situation.
Now, you've been in this business a lot longer than I have. Jaw-dropping, to say the least. Have you ever seen anything like this?
No, but then again, when I started in this business, there was no online mm-hmm. social media. I mean, you know, you might have a blind relationship, a phone situation mm-hmm. where you didn't know or see the other person, but not something like this, where Manti apparently had this mm-hmm. online relationship that went on for a number of months.
And it's still so many questions need to be answered as far as how this all happened, why this all happened. But it's a tremendously sad situation for everyone involved, no doubt.
And what a wake-up call for mm-hmm. any man, woman, boy, girl that's involved in an online relationship.
Yeah, absolutely.
Whew. All right. Thanks, Rob.
You got it.